Hello everybody, welcome to this web chat setup video in Salesforce. Web chat is a pretty powerful tool in Salesforce which can be used in sales and service cloud both. On for sales, the obvious use cases are to connect with new prospects and leads, and for service, for the existing customers can reach out to the service team and then they can connect and then share their issues, experience, share the feedback, and even in cases where the service team is offline, also create cases as well, which we will look into in another video. But let's get started with setting up web chat in Salesforce. We will do a step-by-step method of having this web chat set up in Salesforce. I clicked into the service setup over here, then going into view all, I select chat with customers option. It's a step-by-step guided wizard. We're gonna click start. Put in a name here as chat. For the name of this group, let's put agent chat. I'm gonna select the service agent. So don't change anything over here. The work item size and agent capacity, we'll leave it as it is at 5 and 20. So this is the name of the website that we have to put. So we'll go ahead and put this value. So over here you can select sales or service. Let's just go ahead and select service. So as I said, we will look into setting up an offline support channel at a later video. Let's go ahead and then it's going to give us a code which we will have to make sure that we add in our Visual Force page. We can add it to our custom website as well, but so I have copied this code to be used at a later time. We can do a lot of styling and other things as well, which is not a part of this video, and then we will look into how to do that in a later video. This is a basic setup video for web chat. Now let's go into Visual Force pages. We will be creating a new Visual Force page here. Let's name it as web chat. About that, so we'll put this piece of code here, and this has place for embedded service snippet, which is the code that we copied sometime back. I'll go ahead and replace this comment with that code, and that's it. I'm going to go ahead and save it. Okay. So now let's open this Visual Force page in another window. Let's go to the service console, which can be found from the app launcher. So now we need to go into the omni channel. It says here that this is no agent online. I'm going to go ahead and then select available for chat. So I'm now ready to accept chat messages from users. So now as you can see, there is this window on this, and then again this page is pretty blank. We can have a lot of customization on it. So now we're going to go ahead and click this button, chat with agent. So now as you see, there is some issue that is not allowing us to open the chat window here. So it is an issue related to the security. What we need to do here is that we need to go into our core settings, and then because we did the chat setting. This came on its own. We'll go ahead and edit this one. And because our website is a Visual Force one, the page, I'm just gonna go update it to visualforce.com, because you can see here it has visualforce.com and there is some URL before that. I'm just gonna go ahead and refresh it and hopefully it should work now. Alright, so just put in the first name, last name, email, subject. And click start chatting. Now when I go back into my service console, I should be able to see that there is one new incoming chat as it's coming here. I'm gonna go and accept it. And this is my chat window in my service console sitting with all my cases. I'm gonna go ahead and create. So now it's, as you can see here, I put in a message and then I've received that in my chat window as a customer. And similarly, you can see the message that has come here. Hello agent. So now the chat can be ended by any of the parties here. As a customer, I'm gonna go ahead and then end this chat. I will confirm the chat closure. And in Salesforce, what happens is the chat has ended and a case has been created. So if there is a matching email, then it would have been connected with that particular contact, but because it was not there, it's an open case which has been assigned to this particular agent who was managing the chat. So this gives a good idea of understanding how do you set up a web chat in Salesforce. Stay tuned for more videos. We will be doing more customizations on this in later videos. Thank you so much for watching.